What's going on, guys? And today is all about deploying Windows 10 20H2 with SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right. So Windows 10 20H2, the latest operating system from Microsoft, and how to deploy it within your SCCM environment. So first thing that we need to do is log into your Volume License Center, locate it, and click on the download button. It's going to start downloading. I'm going to click on that little arrow there, and I'm going to click on Save As, and I'm going to drop the ISO within the downloads folder. So I'm going to click on Save, done, right? We are going to click on Open Folder. The downloads folder is going to open up. I'm going to locate that ISO file. I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to mount it. Now, it's automatically going to mount it as the F drive. Now, next thing that I'm going to do is open up my UMC path where I like to drop my installation files. Now, I created a folder called V for version 20H2, and I am basically going to just copy all that, paste it over to copy into its new home, and we're done. Now, go inside your control panel and make sure you are running the latest and greatest Windows ADK as well as Windows PE. If you do not have it, make sure you go here and download the Windows 10 version 2004. Okay, that is the latest one, and that will work with this operating system build. Now, open up your SCCM console, and from here, we are going to go to software, and within software, we are going to open up the operating system node, and we are going to click on operating system images, and from here, we are going to right-click on it and add an operating system image. You're going to get the wizard. I'm going to click on browse and browse to where you drop those source files. We need to locate the install.win file. So select it and click on open. I am actually going to check extract a specific image index. So select that, hit the drop down menu, and then pick your flavor. Once you pick your flavor, we need to pick either you want to do 86-bit or 64. I'm going to pick 64. And for your language, just click on the drop-down menu and then pick your language. Once you do all that, click on next. From here, you're going to provide some information. This is really up to you. It really depends on your environment. So I gave all this information and then click on next. You get a nice little summary. Next again. It's going to export the image. And once it's done, you get this. Green check marks is always a good thing. So click on close. Now from here, we are going to select our image. We're going to right-click on it. And we are going to pick distribute content, and you can get this nice little wizard. Click next here. We're going to click on add, and we are going to pick distribution points, and then pick your DP. Okay, once you pick your DP, click OK and click next here. A nice little summary. Click next. It's going to push out the content to your DP, and once it's done, you're going to get a check mark, which is a good thing, and then click on close. Now before I continue, I will select my new operating system image. And at the very bottom right here where it says content status, I like to make sure that it says success. Green, good to go. If it's still yellow in progress, just give it some time until it changes to green. Now, once you're done, we are going to go inside task sequences, and we're going to right click on that and then create a task sequence. From here, I'm going to leave it as the default. Click next here, provide a task sequence name, and we're going to click on browse and then pick your boot image. Once you pick your boot image, click on next, and then it's time to pick our image package. So click on browse and pick your operating system image. So once you pick your operating system image, click OK. Then we need to provide the following information. We provide your product key, and we are going to enable the administrative password. Okay. Once you enable the administrative password, make sure you enter your password, then confirm it. For this example, I actually uncheck configure task sequence for use within BitLocker because I don't want to use that within my environment. But if you are using BitLocker, just make sure you have that enabled. Okay, click next here. If you are joining this machine into a domain, go for it. If not, I entered work group and click next. This is your installation configuration manager client settings. Click next here. If you are doing a state migration, configure it. For this example, I just unchecked it and then click on next. If you're pushing out updates, configure it here. Again, for this video, I said do not install any software updates. Click next. If you have any applications that you want to push out during the deployment time, add it here. If not, just click next again. A nice little summary. It's going to start doing its magic, and you're done. Green check marks is always a good thing, right? Click close. Now from here, we need to select our new task sequence. We're going to right click on it and we are going to pick deploy. Now within deploy, we are going to click on browse. You get this nice little warning. We're going to click OK, and then you're going to pick your collection. Now for this example, I am picking all unknown computers, and the reason why is because I'm actually using this task sequence for a Pixie boot environment. So we are going to click OK, click next here, and then right there where it says make available to the following, we are going to click on the drop down menu and I'm going to pick only media and Pixie. Click next. You're able to provide a schedule, but I left it as default, which is not turned on. Click next. For the user experience, I left everything as the default. Click next again. For the alert, default, click next. For the DP, again, I didn't change anything. You are able to change it within your environment, but for this video, I left it as the default. Click next again. You get a nice little summary. Click next. It's going to start doing its magic, and once it's done, you got a green check mark, which is awesome. Now, don't go anywhere because you're going to see a fast speed video of actually Pixie booting into a virtual environment, picking the task sequence, and allowing it to deploy Windows 10 20H2. Yes. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up, smash that subscribe button, and do not forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And don't go anywhere because you're going to see a fast video of the process of this task sequence. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.